60 Minutes Rewind.
As a government scientist, James Hansen is taking a risk. He says there are things that the White House doesn't want you to hear, but he's going to say them anyway. Hansen is arguably the world's leading researcher on global warming. He's the head of NASA's top institute studying the climate. But this eminent scientist says that the Bush administration is restricting who he can talk to and editing what he can say. Politicians, he says, are rewriting the science. Well, there'll be none of that tonight, because James Hansen is telling what he knows on 60 Minutes.
You believe that the administration is censoring what you can say to the public?
Well, they're censoring whether or not I can say it. I mean, I say what I believe, if I'm allowed to say it.
What James Hansen believes is that global warming is accelerating. He points to the melting Arctic and to Antarctica, where new data show massive losses of ice to the sea.
Is it fair to say at this point that humans control the climate? Is that possible?
There's no doubt about that. The natural changes, the speed of the natural changes is now dwarfed by the changes that humans are making to the atmosphere and to the surface.
Those human changes, he says, are driven by burning fossil fuels, which pump out greenhouse gases like CO2, carbon dioxide. Hansen says that his research shows man has just 10 years to begin to reduce greenhouse gas emissions, or global warming will reach what he calls a tipping point and will become unstoppable. He says the White House is blocking that message.
In my more than three decades in the government, I've never witnessed such restrictions on the ability of scientists to communicate with the public.
Restrictions like this email that Hansen's Institute received from NASA in 2004. There is a new review process. The White House is now reviewing all climate-related press releases. Why the scrutiny of Hansen's work? Well, his Goddard Institute for Space Studies is the source of respected but sobering research on warming. It recently announced 2005 was the warmest year on record. Hansen started at NASA more than 30 years ago and spent nearly all of that time studying the Earth. How important is his work? We asked someone at the top, Ralph Cicerone, president of the nation's leading institute of science, the National Academy of Sciences.
I can't think of anybody who I would say is better than Hansen. You might argue that there's two or three others as good, but nobody better.
And Cicerone, who's an atmospheric chemist, said the same thing that every leading scientist told us.
Climate change is really happening.
So what is causing the changes?
Well, the greenhouse gases, carbon dioxide and methane and chlorofluorocarbons and a couple of others, which are all the increases in their concentrations in the air are due to human activities. It's that simple.
But if it is that simple, why do climate science reports look like this after they've been edited at the White House, with science labeled not sufficiently reliable? It's a tone of scientific uncertainty that the president set in his first months in office after he pulled out of a global treaty to reduce greenhouse gas emissions.
We do not know how much our climate could or will change in the future. We do not know how fast change will occur, or even how some of our actions could impact it.
That ambiguity annoyed Hansen, so he went public a year and a half ago saying this about the Bush administration in a talk at the University of Iowa.
I find a willingness to listen only to those portions of scientific results that fit predetermined, inflexible positions. This, I believe, is a recipe for environmental disasters.
Ever since he said that, NASA's been keeping an eye on Hansen. NASA let us sit down with him, but only with a NASA representative taping the interview. Other interviews have been denied.
And I object to the fact that I'm not able to freely communicate via the media. National Public Radio wanted to interview me, and they were told that they would need to instead interview someone at NASA headquarters, and the comment was made that they didn't want Jim Hansen going on the most liberal media in the nation. So I don't think that kind of decision should be made on that kind of basis. I think that we should be able to communicate the science.
Politically, Hansen calls himself an independent, and he's had trouble with both parties. He says from time to time the Clinton administration wanted to hear that warming was worse than it was, but Hansen refused to spin the science that way.
Should we be simply doing our science and reporting it rigorously, or to what degree the administration in power has the right to assume that you should be a spokesman for the administration? I've tried to be a straight scientist doing the science and reporting it as best I can.
Dozens of federal agencies report science, and much of it is edited at the White House before it's sent to Congress and the public. It appears that climate science is edited with a heavy hand. These drafts of climate reports were co-written by Rick Piltz for the Federal Climate Change Science Program. But Piltz says his work was edited by the White House to make global warming seem less threatening.
The strategy of people with a political agenda to avoid this issue is to say, there is so much to study way upstream here that we can't even begin to discuss impacts and response strategies. There's much too much uncertainty. And it's not climate scientists who are saying that. It's lawyers. It's politicians.
Piltz worked under the Clinton and Bush administrations, and each year he helped write a report to Congress called Our Changing Planet.
You're responsible for editing Our Changing Planet, and you send a review draft to the White House. What happens?
It comes back with a large number of edits, handwritten on the hard copy by the Chief of Staff of the Council on Environmental Quality.
And the Chief of Staff is whom?
Phil Cooney.
He is a scientist?
No, he's a lawyer. It was a lobbyist for the American Petroleum Institute before going into the White House.
Phil Cooney, the former oil industry lobbyist, became Chief of Staff at the White House Council on Environmental Quality. Piltz says Cooney edited climate reports in his own hand. Here, a line that said Earth is undergoing rapid change becomes maybe undergoing change. Uncertainty becomes significant remaining uncertainty. This line that says energy production contributes to warming is just crossed out.
He was obviously passing it through a political screen. He would put in the word potential or may, or weaken or delete text that had to do with the likely consequences of climate change.
Here, Piltz says that Cooney added this line: the uncertainties remain so great as to preclude meaningfully informed decision making. References to human health are marked out. We obtained the drafts from the Government Accountability Project. The edits you're seeing made it into the final report. Here's that phrase, Earth may be undergoing change, in the report to Congress. Piltz says there wasn't room at the White House for those who disagreed, so he resigned.
I mean, even to raise issues internally is immediately career-limiting. That's why you will find not too many people in the federal agencies who will speak freely about all the things they know, unless they're retired or unless they're ready to resign.
The story will continue after this.